gotta go by what the Bible say for now, but did Peter, when he was in jail, ready to be killed, how we say it, did he fall short from the glory of the Lord and went with the Romans? Did the Romans just up and just crucify him upside down because he was such a good disciple for Jesus and just said, well, we gonna name our basilicas after St. Peter and not St. Jesus? They did you Jesus bad. They did you Jesus bad. Well, maybe these Jesus deserve to be done bad in that sense, because it's Christ, it's Yeshua, it's the anointing of God. They can't do bad. They can do Jesus bad all they want. They did Yeshua bad. I told you the Bible said he got killed two different ways. You don't read your Bible, though. You don't read your Bible. You can't. You would know this stuff. Or you say, Lord, give me insight. Give me wisdom. I'm here, Lord, with an open mind, open spirit, open heart, open soul. Let me receive through the Holy Spirit what I'm supposed to get out this Bible. I got out there. They got in there. Jesus died two different ways. He was born two different ways. He was sent two different ways. Again, St. Nicholas is your Santa. Satan is your Santa. What are you? But Jesus is the reason for the season. We don't put on no big show for him. Like all these other holidays and birthdays. Martin Luther King come up. We got all kinds of things going on for Martin Luther King. He was real close to Jesus. He had a dream. He was anointed. He had a calling on his life. But he ain't Christ. We don't go around putting on all these shows and renting out hotels and this. We just in church. I thought the world needs to see and hear about Jesus Christ. I'm serious. There's so much. There's so much. But you know what? It's crazy. It's crazy how confusing the Roman Catholic Church got the Christian people. It's confusing. And I did a video. It's going up on YouTube tomorrow called Temples versus the Church. And you see why people in church so damn crazy. You see why. This temple, is it a house of prayer or a den of thieves? But we're going to stick to this right now, because this is just got me. Man, take it out your house. I remember I used to have white Jesus here preaching. This is all idolatry, man. Especially if you don't look like the way the man looked when you walked the face of the earth. Even more idolatry. Ain't nothing wrong with having a picture of your Lord and Savior. They got rid of all the pictures, all the real pictures, because they don't want you to remember the real person. They want to flood your mind with the Jesus we see in the pictures, so that's all you'll know. Remember, we're some visually impaired people. Not that we can't see, but the only way we see is by something being in front of our eyes. That's not faith, really. That's the opposite of faith. That's how I know a lot of us is not walking by faith, because we have to see everything to believe it. That's why a lot of people can't believe Jesus or believe in God, because you're like Thomas. You're doubting that he exists. Thomas didn't doubt that he existed. Thomas is one, oh, that ain't you. I gotta feel the marks. I gotta do this. I gotta do that. Okay, Thomas. That's still doubt and unbelief. But Jesus said, blessed is the ones who don't see and believe, Thomas. You see and believe in. Blessed is the one who don't see me, Thomas, and believe in me. This is what Christ said, okay? I know it's hard to believe in stuff you can't see because everything is so visually right in front of us. All we can do is say, okay, I see it, I want it. I see it, I gotta have it. I see it, I see it, I see it. But you gotta read God's word in order to see it. And that's the point. If God's word just flashed before your eyes and you could see everything acted out in front of your eyes, maybe we would believe it then. But no, that's not faith. I'm not dealing with that. If it's not faith, I'm not dealing with it. It's got to be faith in order for this thing to work for us. Faith comes by what? Hearing the word of God. If we're hearing the word of God, then what is it we hearing? We're hearing lies from the Romans. We're hearing lies from the Pope. We're hearing lies. And I'll tell you what. Ain't no way in hell these two. Look, this show Christ on the cross, which he's not in the cross. He better be in your heart or on the right hand of God somewhere. He should not be here, but this cover it all up. Can you see that? Can you see that, YouTube? YouTube, you see that, right? Yeah, this. And you the Pope. Ooh, the Pope. No. I love Pope Francis, Pope Benedict, Pope whoever. It's not the Pope, the person. It's the entity. The entity, the organization, the Roman Empire have been out against Israel, Jerusalem, the children of Israel. And I wouldn't put it past them suckers if they is down with Trump. These are the people that sold you into slavery. Hello, Trump. That's the president. I call the people by their name. The presidential palace. That's what it used to be called. Mm-hmm. Then they call it the White House. Scare all you niggas out from running for the office. If it's the White House, how can a black man run for office? That's the White House. Fear. Mm-hmm. Make your ass not want to even run for president. And you was created to rule. The queen. I got that damn video on her too. Oh, I got all my stuff over here. I'm trying to tell y'all, I got these videos I'm working on. Yes, I got something for the queen, okay? You see that? I got something for the queen. I wouldn't know if the Egyptians is in it, but can you see I got something for them too? They was down with slavery, but this time around, I bet you these people right here is down with Donald Trump trying to make Jerusalem the capital of Israel. I'm going to do my research on that for y'all, but I know before I even get it out there, it's going to come out in the news that, yeah, the Pope is going along with President Trump, the Queen, the United Kingdom. They all in cahoots with this new world order. It's really going down, y'all. Check them purple hearts out that's flying all around. Them purple hearts signifies more than purple love. Now listen to me. I think purple is royalty. And how dare they would take a color that means royalty and make it so wicked. But that's what people do. Remember, it's wickedness in high places. That just don't mean the air. That means seated in high places. These are high places, people. This is a high place. The queen is a high place. Donald Trump and his damn flag is a high place. You better, you know what the Bible says? You better bind what you bind on earth, you bind in heaven. What you loose on earth, you loose. You better bind some of this wickedness up. Talking about you praying for everybody on Facebook. You need to start praying for the people that really matter in the eyes of God. These people that gave you a religion that oppress you, depress you, suppress you, stress you. These people over here, I just put her butt back. These people right here. Matter of fact, I'll bring my whole damn bucket. I'm going to save it for my video. It's after Christmas now. But it's called the Abominable Holidays. I'm going to show you what the Abominable Holidays is. for you Christians, us believers, who ain't even supposed to be worshiping this stuff. It's not a part of us. These people here gave it to you. These people, I'm talking about the Pope. The Pope,